Oh. I can always hear him sort of muttering and mumbling. Welcome back, friends. Today, we're listening to We Don't Talk About Bruno from Disney's Encanto. I absolutely love Disney movies and Disney songs for the way they're produced, the way they're put together, and more importantly, the way that they're sung. And this song is trending at number one on YouTube, so I know it must be good, and I know you guys must be listening to it on repeat. If that's you who's been listening to this song nonstop, let me know in the comments down below. But I'm so excited to listen to this song for the first time. By the way, if you're new around here, hello. My name is Cody McManus. I'm a music producer from Canada, so I'm really excited to give my thoughts and opinions along the way. If you like what I have to say about We Don't Talk About Bruno, be sure to give this video a big thumbs up, hit that like button down below. It really helps me out a ton, and feel free to hit that subscribe button so that you don't miss out on any more reaction videos from me. But let's throw on these headphones and get right into it, because I am so ready to listen to the number one song on YouTube right now. This is We Don't Talk About Bruno from Disney's Encanto. Here we go.
What if you didn't understand what he saw?
Then you better figure it out, because it was coming for you.
We don't talk about Bruno.
Oh, cool.
No, no, no. We don't talk about Bruno. But it was my wedding day.
It was our wedding day.
We were getting funky.
And there wasn't a cloud in the sky.
No clouds allowed in the sky.
You know,
I love how much personality Disney songs have in them. Like, you can very clearly hear the characters' voices. They are sung so well. I don't know who the actors are for this. I'll have to look that up, but I love the way that they're sung. The vocals are so loud. They overpower the music. That's one thing with Disney songs that I absolutely love. They are so vocally driven.
With a mischievous grin.
Don't go.
You tell me a story or am I?
I'm sorry, maybe that go wrong.
Bruno says it looks like rain.
Where's the heat alone?
Oh, there's very cool vocal panning going on too. Wherever the characters move on the screen is where the voice goes. So we heard his voice move over to the left side. If you're wearing headphones or have some good speakers in front of you, you might notice this. But this isn't what you normally hear in traditional music that you hear on the radio or that you listen to on Spotify, Apple Music, wherever you listen to music. Normally it's the vocals right up the middle, but this is actually cool. I haven't heard this in a Disney song before where the vocal actually pans to where they are. This is really cool. Oh, we get some strings?
We don't talk about Bruno.
Wow, more vocal panning. Oh!
I can always hear him sort of muttering and mumbling. I associate him with the sound of falling sand.
Yo! This is sick. We have so many vocalists in this song. This is cool. I don't think we typically get this from a lot of Disney stuff. Normally there's only a couple vocalists. We might have like a duet in a Disney song, but this is already the third vocalist that we've had. I really like the modern take on music. This isn't just like an older song. This is a very modern feel. Like, she's almost like rapping here. This is cool.
Mumbling, I associate him with the sound of falling sand.
Sick. Another singer. This song is cool. This is such a cool part of the song too. It's super bass driven. Boom, 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 boom. It just keeps running the whole time. It's what's holding the entire song together. There's not too many other elements going on other than the vocal and this bass line. Oh, spooky. Oh, beautiful. Oh, I love that. That's such a cool way to introduce more vocals. So we started with just the one, and then we got the harmony as she passed by that woman, and then we got a third harmony as she passed by that guy again. That's so cool.
He told me my fish would die the next day.
Oh, no.
He told me I'd grow a glass, and just like he said that all my hair would disappear. Now look at my hair.
That guy's my favorite.
When your prophecy is fair. He told me that the life of my dreams would be promised and someday be mine.
Her voice is beautiful. It's almost an acapella. We got some pizzicato strings going on, some like nice plucked strings, and that's about it. I want to hear her sing that again. She has a beautiful voice.
He told me that the life of my dreams would be promised and someday be mine.
Oh my goodness.
He told me that my power would grow like the grapes that thrive on the vine.
Wow. The people who cast for Disney are so, so impressive. Her voice is so beautiful. There's so much emotion to it. It's almost like she's speaking the part because it's very theatrically sung, but then she has these beautiful like belty notes that really just fill up so much space. It's just her voice basically there with a couple of strings. Impressive. Okay, this song's building a bit now. I want not a sound out of you. I can hear him now. Bruno. Yeah, about that Bruno. I really need to know about Bruno. Give me the truth and the whole truth, Bruno. Isabella, your boyfriend. Oh. What a beautiful transition. Man, Disney composers are so good. The way we drop into this chord here preps us for something to hit. And then we're back. I love it. Wow, we have so many vocals going on again. There have been so many singers introduced in this single song, and now they're really using this panning. Everybody's singing a different line on different sides. It's so cool. What's really cool about this part of the song too is they're using a lot of acoustic elements. So we have like a bass guitar holding it together. The drums sound like a real drum kit. It's not like a synthesized or electronic drum kit or anything like that. I think it's pretty much predominantly real instruments, which is really cool. We do have some of the strings going on too. Oh, wow. Oh my gosh, just like that, that's it. Wow, guys, this is so amazing. We Don't Talk About Bruno. I see why it's number one on YouTube. Beautiful, beautiful song. So many parts going on. I couldn't believe all the singers that we had. I really like it. Now, I haven't seen the whole movie yet, so I'm not entirely sure of exactly what's going on within the whole context of the movie, but you can tell that there's a lot of voices and it's almost like a confusing time for the main character. And that's so beautifully emphasized at the end of the song when we have all of these voices and all these different people singing all of these different parts at the same time. It's almost overwhelming, which you get a sense of in the film. I love the way that they use the music to help further tell a story. Absolutely beautiful, amazing song. I enjoyed it so much. Guys, if you enjoyed this video and my reaction to it, be sure to give this video a big thumbs up down below. Hit that like button. It helps me out a ton. And if you enjoy my reaction videos, think about hitting that subscribe button so that you don't miss out whenever I post any more reaction videos just like this. Anyways, hope you guys enjoyed a ton. Thank you so, so much for watching and have a great rest of your day. Peace.